Hi, everyone. Welcome to Black and White Recovery. My name is Lee, and I am a newcomer. I'm joined by my sponsor, Ian.
Oh, you put a name on it. Hi, everybody. How are you?
Is that straight up enough?
Yeah, that's straight up enough.
I'm wondering how straight up enough I was going to be about this, worrying about my own public perception based on doing this show.
Right.
All right, so let's have weird ground rules right now. Okay. Let's set aside all new weird ground rules right now, right?
Okay.
For those of you listening, don't ever take advice from me. Don't listen to me. I can only give you my perspective on the situation. I stopped going to meetings 10 years ago that had nothing to do with what occurred from Thursday to Saturday, for God's sakes. And we'll cover that. Here's the first question. Am I sending this episode out to all parties concerned so they can hear my story?
Are you?
I'm asking you. It's a sponsor question.
You could.
Would it be beneficial to anybody involved?
No.
So that's just an ego thing?
Yeah.
Okay, then that won't happen. Okay, well, I'm going to ask the next question because this came up and I was discussing it with my mother and I told my mom. I came clean with my family. Do I tell my daughter?
I wouldn't.
Now, is that an ego thing on your part?
No, it's just... She doesn't deserve, you know, is she going to be disappointed if you tell her?
Yeah.
Okay. Injure them or others. You're injuring her.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Those are the ground rules.
I wouldn't lie to her.
I wouldn't lie to her either.
Yeah, my dad hasn't had drink in 25 years. You might have to say, well, there was this one.
Technically, I made it to the anniversary, so it was 26 before the first
one. All right. 26. You know, you don't want to turn her into a liar.
Okay, that's done. And I'm going to ask before we get into the heat of this, I should do no more negative shit to the parties that I think that have harmed me. And I would imagine at some point I would have to make amends to them for doing the shitty stuff I'm doing to them.
Yes.
But you and I both know the shitty things I have done, and they're pretty epic.
They're pretty effective, yeah.
And just for the sake, I'm going to try to keep names out of this, right? That's fair for everybody involved.
Yes.
Anonymity wise, I don't need to fuck over anybody else's business from here on out. I mean, you can certainly go online and find out who I am through the show and channel and find out some of the people connected with it, if that's what you want to choose. I just wanted to get this down because I've had a very pious attitude about what the fuck do you need AA for? What do you, you know, it. You know, I'll be the first to admit it, that I've had a very holier than thou walk on water kind of attitude about remaining sober without going to meetings and having gone to meetings. Is that a fair statement?
Yes.
Okay.
Very true.
All right. All the ground rules are out of the way. Mm-hmm. For those of you who don't know, 3 months ago, first week of July, we've covered it on this show. I broke up with my ex-fiance. Are we actually going full video? You'd probably want to put your face on if that's the case.
Yeah, why not?
Well, you need to adjust the camera.
Oh, well, I don't have a monitor. There we go. Oh, yeah, there's my head.
Okay, hey. There you go. I'm live from my parents' house.
Okay.
Hi, everyone. All right, let's be real and let's be honest. At the very end of August, beginning of July, I was given a drop-dead date for things to change in our relationship. And in my mind, without communicating it, I felt the only way to make those changes was for us to be apart and for us to, you know, make ourselves successful independently. And if the roads cross, the roads cross, right? That's kind of the attitude I had. I've got a lot of time with her. I've got business with her. I have debts with her. I have a lot of stuff. So we had been... remaining friends for the last 3 months and doing stuff as recently as a few weeks ago where we've gotten together, gone and done things. She asked me out of the blue What do you think about me going and training with your coach and friend? Do you think it would be beneficial to me? And I said, I think it would be. And in fact, I texted him. He goes, she's thinking of training with me, bro. What do you think? And I said, I think it's great. Maybe she's trying to build a connection with me, but I think it's really healthy for her. I think you're a great teacher for that kind of thing.
Right. Starting to have some things in common.
They turned that into a personal relationship and started going out and then started hooking up. That's only been going on for about the last week and a half, maybe 2 weeks, I assume, based on the timeline that I can piece together.
Mm-hmm.
He texted me on Friday, well after they had started hooking up, and was kind of feeling me out. And he's like, what's going on, bro? How you doing? I said, well, you know, I'm coming back to live half my time up in LA because that's where I am right now with my parents. I'm taking care of them a few days a week in LA. And the rest of the time I'll spend down in San Diego focusing on my daughter. I said, so it'll give me a chance to come train with you again on Monday, which would technically be tomorrow based on our conversation. He had a chance right there. Had a chance right there.
Yeah.
Right? You had a chance right there. I know the timeline now, so you had a chance right there. Nothing was said to me. Diana. Yeah, well. My ex then brought up during the week the, hey, I went out with him. Hey, I kissed him, which is almost a code word for I banged him. That's the way she played it last time. Yeah, no, she did it that way last time when she met a guy during our last breakup, which was fine because I know what she's after. She wants someone that is beneficial, that makes her feel pretty and special, that isn't me, because I quote unquote don't tell her those things, which I don't think I've ever said a negative thing about her in my entire life. The only thing I say about her that's negative is she has a negative attitude, and I've always been trying to change that. But she hears everything out of my mouth as negativity towards her, and I hear everything out of her mouth as negativity towards me. That's just how relationships go. But we've remained friends and business partners all through that. So I said, well, I'm not really cool with it because there are a billion people on the planet. I completely get that you need attention and focus, and I understand he makes you feel pretty and special and whatever it is, whatever's working for you. Because I've already worked it out of my mind that this is just literally a hookup for fun and sex, because I know him. That's the kind of guy he is. This is not the guy you're keeping indefinitely. I don't want to throw his shit out there, but we're talking multiple relationships. I know for a fact he's working multiple girls simultaneously, like he's a player. Okay. Yeah. But if she's cool with that, whatever. Mm-hmm. I'm not here to judge anybody. I've spent time with him. He's a friend of mine.
Right.
Then on Thursday, I was told, okay, well, nothing's going to happen. I'm going to just be home alone. And so I sent a Craigslist driver by the house to go take a photo of the house, which might qualify as stalking. And I'm recording that. But he was over. I confronted them. I told him he was a piece of shit. I told her it was not cool. And so then I started to destroy his life first, systematically. I literally wrote, first thing I didn't want to do was get in the car and go up there and confront him. This is where I started to drink. This is about Thursday, because this went on until about Saturday morning. I drank for a long time. I started drinking. I think after she told me on Wednesday, I had the first bottle of Tito's. Then on Thursday, I was drinking during the day slowly and not working. And on Friday, I was drinking and, you know, not processing. You know, I couldn't function for those days once I had the information. After I dropped my daughter off and her day was done with me, I would say Wednesday night I went and got my daughter. So I went all the way till Saturday. I got a couple hours of sleep somewhere on Friday, but I got up on Saturday to go see my daughter. Okay. Just to give the timeline correctly. I confronted him. I confronted her. I wrote a letter to the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu team that I was a part of, that he coaches, and said, hey, look, you guys need to know that I sent somebody over there to train with him. It was my ex-fiance. And I realized that's my ex, and she's got a part in this too. But he used information to get himself laid. So if you're cool with that as a wife or a sister or a daughter or somebody you send over, I'm just telling you, this dude's a straight up predator. He made it like he had to know, like this is a bro code thing. Like straight up, it's right. A bro code thing.
Right.
Right. And I've run into a couple of people that say the bro code is bullshit. I don't think the bro code is bullshit. I think there are some lines
either, but I've been a victim of people throwing it to the curb myself.
Okay. Whatever the case, I did what I thought was appropriate, having referred someone on a business level to him, right? Mm-hmm. Then taking advantage of that and moving it into a personal relationship, and then using the information he knew about our relationship to weasel action. And she's a willing participant. I'm not going to lie about any of that. I'm not downplaying her side, my side, or his side. I'm just giving my perspective. She's right. She's an adult and she can do whatever she wants. I'm not making a move to make that situation better, and I haven't. And we've talked about it previously. I don't know if we were ever moving in the correct direction of getting back together. Certainly, it would require us for probably seeing other people and to, you know, see what we really want out of life. But me moving back to LA would have certainly helped a lot of the situation, a great deal.
Right.
I certainly wanted to go train again. There's no way I could train. Like, the minute I knew it, I knew I couldn't go train, and I lost a friend in the transaction. Like, I can't even look at him. Like, I can't be cool about it. So I wrote that letter, and I sent it to 30 people on the jiu-jitsu team. Then I wrote one of the most horrific Yelp reviews that I've ever put together in my entire life. So at 3 a.m. when he was done banging away and decided to answer his phone to me, he goes, yeah, I didn't think, bro. I'm a piece of shit, blah, blah, blah. I told him what I did, right? Because I sent screenshots. I did the whole thing. Like, you got to show the scorched earth or it's not fun.
Right. It's not effective anyway.
Right. And in my drunken rage, I may have yelled at her for a while, and she claims she may have recorded it, and she's threatening to send it to my daughter. Like, it's all the good drama that the reason why you don't shit where you eat. I'm the guy. I'm the guy why you don't shit where you eat. Like, it's happening in real time for everybody. So I said, I'll tell you what, you be a man, you stop this shit. You can deal with the 30 people and handle that. You can say whatever you want. You can say I was hacked. You can say it was bullshit or I don't know what he's talking about, but you can get around that, right? You can get around 30 emails. I said, I'll take down the Yelp review. If you're a man, we're square. And you drop this shit, and I don't get a whiff of you going back to it. He goes, okay, that's fair. I talked to her on Saturday. After all this has happened, I knew she was in a bad mood because I had talked to her on the phone. Oh, he's not going to want to have anything to do with me. I'm going to just take a shower and drink some Tito's myself and go to bed. 6 o'clock in the afternoon. Okay. I was going to drop off something that I had picked up in Vegas that she needed, and I was going to just drop it off because I thought it would cheer her up. Her car was parked out on the street, which means she's not parking in the garage. The garage was slightly pushed open because he drives a truck. It doesn't take a fucking rocket scientist to put this one all together. They assumed that I would just hire another driver or something else, so they just moved the car to keep it all clean. I'm sure everybody's perspective on the fact is that, I was never there. Okay. I never went onto the property. I didn't, like, I could see that the garage didn't shut all the way. It was shutting on his vehicle. So I threw the shit at her house and sent them both a text. And then they started to play the stalker card of, you're up front. He claimed he wasn't there. I don't appreciate it. He got all tough guy with me. I said, you know, if either of you would just man up and say you were going to keep doing it, I probably would have been okay with it at this point. And that's the truth. If anybody would have just been honest with me and go, we don't really give a fuck. We're going to just keep doing it because we're having fun. Okay, what am I going to say? Okay. All right, I'll drop it. So I then continued to scorch the earth. Oh, by the way, I stopped drinking at that point. You can't drink and drive. The reason I drank in the first place was to keep me from driving and to keep me from literally doing something even stupider than I already did. Like, me stupid and drunk with a keyboard is bad. I'm actually quite surprised. I think I did the Yelp review. I re-updated the Yelp review and rewrote it now so it's more coherent. The letters that I wrote to everybody were not as coherent. They were a little drunk, but they conveyed the point. I debated going back and resending them all on Saturday after getting the second confirmation while they both played the, oh, I'm afraid you're stalking me. Because I called him at 6. He picked up the phone. I'm like, put her on. And she had already turned off her phone because she doesn't want to like deal with me while she's getting laid. I get that. Right. So I called him enough times and literally within a few minutes, somebody who technically had their phone off called me. Did I hear you were out front? Okay. Don't be stupid. Like, why is everybody playing dumb with me? Like I don't get it.
Reading you right. Like
I have not drank since Friday. So I've got two days. And so I updated him. I think he's probably going to lose his black belt out of this deal who didn't like the whole situation. He was the only one who really reached out to me and asked me real questions. And so I talked to him quite long on social media and sent him a copy of the updated Yelp review that is my position. It's taking a lot of energy for me not to want to run a full-on Facebook ad campaign that points at the Yelp campaign.
Right.
But that's just me and my ego. So I get that. Right. So that's why I haven't done it. But I've thought about it repeatedly for the better part of a couple of hours. I had a high level of anxiety for the last couple of days. I hadn't eaten. I still haven't had a full night's sleep since Wednesday. I did get a nap this afternoon, which helped greatly. I actually had some carbs today for the first time. I'll give all the info. I lost approximately 8 pounds in 4 days. The final total was three bottles of Tito's. And for those of you who think that, oh, what are you talking about? They're not, I'm going to pull up the photo because I took a picture of it. I'm actually, it's in my new category called Betrayal.
Nice album name.
I thought so. Okay, hold on. I'll pull that up. But not the big one, not the little one, the one in the middle, the one that's easy to hold like that. So, three of them, three Tito's was the final tally. I don't technically know if I'm done. I don't know if I'll need that crutch to kind of just wheeze my way through a couple of bad and long days. I'm trying not to make historically bad decisions that are just designed to hurt her or him, which having you as a sponsor is not helpful on that topic because you believe in a scorched earth policy. You do. You don't care if the cops come. I love the whole, we're going to have the cops come over. Dude, my address is on my card. Like, what are they? They're going to look at my driver's license. I'm going to say that's my house. I guarantee there's mail in the front door of that house with my name on it. There is personal property in that house, even though I've left 3.5 months ago. It'll turn into a domestic dispute. It'll look bad for everybody involved. Like, I don't even know what the threat was here. You can't. I love the whole concept that they were coming up with, but look at my driver's license. I'm coherent. This isn't going to go sideways for you guys.
Right.
And now you're all caught up. I've made it to Sunday night.
Okay. So when people say it's usually romances or finances that make somebody pick up, this would be one of them.
It was. And I'll tell you why it was in this particular case. It's not the romance with her. I was pretty okay with it. And I knew at some point she'd probably go out. I'm a big boy. Mm-hmm. You know, that's an ego, you know, personal property, macho bullshit thing, right? I got over that last time. I would have probably have gotten, I did get over it last time. And she was literally borderline living with the guy. In this particular case, because she goes, oh, I think you'll get over it in time. I got over all your shit and all the crazy shit you've done and all the shit you admitted to while you were drunk. And I admitted to everything. I literally laid everything out. I was really good at scorching my earth. Alcohol is a damn good truth serum. I swear to God, I couldn't even stop myself from saying shit.
Yeah, usually takes the filters off.
It did. I'm more upset about him. I really liked him. He was a good friend. Yeah. He was trusted. That's the betrayal that hurts. It's not her. It's not her. He knew the situation. Just complimenting her and listening to her would have made it all work out. That and a little Tito's and you got her. Like, there's no question. She was vulnerable and in the right spot, and I know how it all went down. I'm a big boy. His answer of I didn't know or I didn't think about it or playing his proverbial dumb for me.
Right.
Is just mind-blowing.
Insult of intelligence.
It is. It is to me. It is to me. Right. And then for them to put on a huge show for me on Saturday morning and tell me, no, that's not going to go on. And he's not even going to give me the time of the day. His business is more important, and still go back to it. Mm. And I actually told her on the phone before she quote unquote went to take a shower to get laid. She's going to go to bed early, i.e. get laid. I know the new code word. I'm drunk. She has to drink because part of her doesn't like doing this, right? But it takes the filter off, and she does like having sex with him. I'm sure of that. That's a very adult statement by me. I'm cool with that.
Yeah.
What I didn't like was I told her just before I started to head out to my daughter's flag event and drop off her stuff, was that I told her on the phone, I said, you guys could just be putting on one tremendous act. You are that smart. I gave her a chance right there. I said it to her physically on the phone. You guys could be putting on one tremendous act for me just to get me to stop. Because if I really do put my thumb down, I really can destroy his business. I really can destroy your business. And you know her as well as I do. Her image is everything to her.
Yeah.
She lied to her best friend and didn't tell him that it was actually going on because she didn't want to hear his opinion, right? And I literally was able to scoop in and talk to him on Friday while this was happening and had him stolen away. Like, he was going to be Team Lee in the divorce.
Mm-hmm.
And she asked me kindly on Saturday, please don't do that. Okay. Just don't hook up with this guy again. I'm playing fair with everybody. I'll give everybody what they want. Just not this guy. Literally not this guy. And so everybody lied to me again. I did not drink on Saturday because of it. I took that one in stride. I had a high level of anxiety and chest pain. Which was new for me. I've never had anxiety like that for a couple of days. And
where did that come from?
I think it was being lied to again after I made everybody what I thought we all had a simple understanding. You guys made career bad moves. I made a career bad move. Let's let it all end in a 48-hour car crash and everybody moves forward. But you had to lie to me again. Hmm. Not cool. Not cool. There you go. That's everything. I can think of nothing else.
So what were you feeling when you picked up?
I know this is going to sound really crazy to everybody. It's not her. I completely get her side of this whole thing. I want her to be happy. I love her. I want her to be happy. Why him? Literally, the why him thing is the most painful thing in this whole thing. Why him? I could even pick ancillary people that we know where I'd be more understanding if it was somebody like in our business world, right? Right. I'd be okay with it. Mm-hmm. Why this guy? Like, why the one of the four or five people that I like actually text and talk to and do shit with? Why? But I'll give her credit. She followed the protocols on Thursday when she found out about it. She called you. She called James.
Yeah.
James is a piece of shit. If you're watching this, James or Bruce, you guys are a piece of shit. James just called me once. Literally. Nice. Yeah. Oh, okay. Call me when you're done. I said, I told him the whole story, and I go, James, if your wife, okay, fiance, for the sake of better terms, living with her for a period of time, that's money, everything, business, that's my wife, right? Your wife sleeps with your best friend after you've been separated for a few months. How would you handle it? And here's exactly what he said. I'd be happy for them. I said, listen, you fat fuck, you're lying. You are lying. There's nobody that would be okay with this. Mm-hmm. There's nobody. There's no guy that would be okay with this. There's no guy. I know that there are people going, it's not a reason to drink, Lee. It was a reason to keep me from driving a car. I'll give myself credit. And I made it clear to you what my goal was to keep me from leaving where I was going.
You didn't want to get in a car and become homicidal.
Right. Right. Because it's the him thing. It's not the her thing.
Right. And if you're in, and if you're in a frustrated homicidal mode and you can't do nothing about it, it usually turns itself inside out to suicide.
Right. And casually, I've been looking for someone to go out with. I haven't gone out on dates. You know that. I tell you everything. Have you heard me talk about any women over the last 3 months?
No.
Nope. Been focusing on me. There are a couple of situations that I was kind of poking and prodding at to take a look at. I didn't go back and look at exes. I didn't do like. I knew that I was occasionally going up there. The thing that bothered me the most was I knew that I was coming back up here. I knew that I'd be splitting my week back in LA from San Diego. So that's kind of another kicker that was kind of a weird twist to this whole thing. But you learn, right? It's a growing process. Like, I don't go to meetings, so I don't have that weird stigma of, oh, I got to hang my head and go get the newcomer's chip and do it all over again. I'm happy to talk to you. I'm happy to put my shit out into the open air. I think the only people who listen to this are real program people anyway. I don't think that there's a huge audience of people that are spying on my life to get inside dirt. This is probably the only show that I'm real on.
I'm sure there's a few that cross over to my You Deserve Better page and things like that.
Maybe. And I'm not going to be shocked if the party's involved.
Not many Phoenix cancer conquerors, I don't think, listen to this, no.
And I'll safely say this because I'm sure that a few of the parties involved are probably going to listen to this show. They'd be stupid not to.
The episode's about them.
It is. It is. And I'm happy for her if she's happy. At the end of the day, I'm trying to be adult about that.
Yeah.
Just not him. it's already done now. Well, and you've already put on a show. And you've already lied to me. So you might as well stay all in. But now
it's not fun to them anymore.
No, it isn't. Ultimately what her goal had to be was to either one, burn a bridge with me and get on with her life, or to get me to notice in some very dramatic fashion. Right. Those are the two reasons we didn't put a whole lot of thought into the fuckly of this whole thing. I said, really? Mm. It had to cross your mind a couple of times. And if you didn't, then you're lying.
Right.
Swept up in the moment, it really hasn't been going on that. Whatever. Okay. Whatever. At some point, both of you had to stop and think, what's Lee?
I don't know, bro. I wasn't thinking. You're right. I fucked up.
Okay. And in her case, we just didn't sit around and say, hey, fuck Lee. No, I don't think you guys did that. I think internally, both of you were waiting for the time bomb to go off, knowing my personality. And they got the car crash and explosion that they were after. And if they continue to do it after, because they want to continue to do it after, there's nothing I can do about it.
Right.
I've cut her out of my business life. She can handle her own scandal, her debts, her bills, everything. She doesn't need money from me anymore. She's made it very clear. This is her path. Yay. I've still been financially sending her money and taking care of her. Probably on some level, I should still continue to do that because we've accrued debts that need to be paid off. That's the correct thing to do. Maybe in time I will, when it's not so tingly for me. But you already saw what I did from a business perspective.
Right. For her. Well, for debts,
and I handled it, and I handled her side very professionally. Right.
Well, yeah. Yeah, I mean, word spread fast. I told you Saturday morning I got a text from one of the students saying, hey, did they break up? I go, yeah, a few months ago. I go, but there's other stuff going on, and they don't want to work together anymore. That's all I'm saying.
And that's the correct way to handle it. You know, good luck in your future endeavors, and don't burn your bridges. Then, in regards to him, I really do have to go through Facebook to see if I'm running a campaign on some kind of weird slanderous mission to shut him down and send him back to being a drywaller. I'm just wondering if ass or pussy is really worth $1 million.
It's never cost me that much.
Okay, I get that. We're just talking about a hookup for the future. I'm actually, you already know the deal that I'm kind
of. I've been long-term deals that have cost me plenty of dough. I just had a 4-month deal, cost me about 30 grand. Dinner every night, and the two kids, and.
But if you know her and you know the situation. Right. Paying all that stuff, right? Yeah. And you know the deal that I'm currently working on that's about to go off before the end of the year.
Right.
I haven't given you all the details, but actual TV, that whole business model. It's $1 million deal. Like, it's literally, I was selected.
Probably more. Guy,
probably more. Mm-hmm. And what's the number one thing for the girl that you know that I was engaged to? What is her number one thing? What is she all about?
Money.
Right. 100%. Mm-hmm. And she just pissed it away over getting laid. Mm-hmm. That's the part that I'm kind of shocked by. Like, she doesn't have any sight to this. She already knew that my business was picking back up and that I was getting my shit together. Whatever. There you go.
Yeah.
Be sponsorly?
Well, I would tell you to go do a 90-90 and read some pages out of the big book, but you're not going to do that.
No. You would be correct.
So, I mean, that's it. Just.
Even doing this was questionable to me.
Well, we've said it on this show plenty of times that if you're homicidal or suicidal, just go drink. Don't do any of that other shit. We've said
throw
that.
Throw the cars into the ocean. And
we've throw the car keys in the ocean, sit at home and
drink yourself to blackout.
When you're done. And
you should have told me to throw the
also said that we're both from the fabric. You know, you don't pick up no matter what.
Correct. Which, it was an ego thing for me to have 26 years. It was.
Right. And those two sayings are completely hypocritical of one another.
They are.
You know, so it's okay to pick up if you're suicidal or homicidal.
Completely.
And ride it out. And you know, that's it. I have people that I've got sober with that we always talked about, you know, finding out if, you know, one of our friends was HIV positive, and this was way before they had anything to help it. So we knew it was a death sentence. And, you know, me and a couple of guys looked at each other and been like, oh, I'd never stay sober through that. And then one of the guys I was having that discussion with, I mean, we all kind of had a pact that, you know, if you got the death sentence,
go have fun.
And he was diagnosed with stage 4 lymphoma, and he went through the treatment and it didn't work. And it's like, hey, you want to go to the dope house? And he's like, no. And he said something that made a little sense to me regarding that fact, because I'm the guy that's not worried about using and dying. I'm worried about using and living. And, he said something that made sense. He's like, listen, when I got here, I didn't love myself and nobody loved me. Now, if I pick up, yes, I'm definitely not going to love myself. But I'm also not going to be able to love anybody else, and that I would miss. So I want to be able to love all of you guys in my last 6 months. And I want you to love me back, blah, blah, blah. And he died, he died sober. But you know, my hat's off to, you know, there was something that had changed from him.
I didn't, for the record, I never thought that I'd make it to my death. So
right, I understand. I understand. No, it's a little bit different topic.
And the only reason I'm having this discussion right now with you, because we talked about this right after.
Well, you want to start over? You want a fresh start?
Right. Well, no. Are we talking about the tiramisu? Are we talking about eating too much pizza? Are we talking about smoking too much coffee? You and I both agreed this was totally different. This is not about taking an unprescribed Vicodin. This is something totally different. This is the real deal. You full on went on a legit, that's what you're doing.
Right.
And that's what it was. And I knew that at some point I would probably do that. It was in my makeup to do it at some point. I just thought it would be based on, holy shit, I made $5 million.
I mean, everybody thinks I'm going to do that every day, but something usually having to do with going to a meeting almost every day, that's not what crosses my mind. It's, you know, it's blowing $100 on the Philadelphia Eagles thinking they could score more than 10 freaking points tonight. It's eating half a chocolate cake when I'm not hungry. It's buying something that I don't need. Man, I went through my storage bin the other day. I have 8 shirts that are exactly the same as 8 other shirts. It means I bought them, put them in the closet, a couple weeks later, a couple months later, whatever, didn't wear them, whatever, bought them again. And, you know, now I just threw them on eBay for $7, probably $50 shirts. Stupid ass. So, I mean, is that a sober thing to do? I don't know. I'm not drinking about it.
Well,
do I feel stupid? Of course I feel stupid, but you know, my disease has many other faces. They don't take me down like alcohol or drugs would take me down. Well, the gambling could probably do a pretty good job
Great job. Don't kid yourself.
It's hard to overdose on gambling. It's hard to overdose on gambling. So, you know, and again, as long as I keep it cheaper than therapy, it's okay. And, you know, that's my justification for it. But plus, I gamble with guys that I really don't have to pay if I lose too much. So, but that's a whole other issue.
But again, it's the question always on this show is sober behavior.
You weren't able to gamble. You weren't able to eat. You weren't able to smoke cigarettes. You know, 2 packs an hour. You weren't able to drink coffee 3 pots at a time. So you picked up some Tito's.
And I picked good. I mean, look, I was eyeballing it for a long time. Thanks to being a fan of Bert Kreischer, I was all aware of the Tito's vodka thing.
Right.
But trust, you know, and I was thinking about this because I knew it was going to be substantial. Like, this was it. Just for you guys to be inside my mind before this all goes down. There wasn't a whole, I just slipped and I fell into a bottle. No, it was calculated. Got into the car, drove over while I was stone cold sober. Right. And I looked at the, who's the guy from Ghostbusters? Dan Aykroyd. He's got his own brand of vodka that's filtered with diamonds. That's crazy. Comes in a skull head. And it was $89. And I literally looked at it for a good period of time. And said, no, I'll take the $20 bottle of Tito's, thanks. Because I figured if you're going to do it, don't dabble in it. I'm sure that there's an alcohol poisoning thing that probably could have transpired. Probably, because that's a real thing, for those of you who don't know. I'm just not sure of what that limit is on a guy who's 240 pounds like me. Actually, I'm not 240. I'm 220. I'm actually 223 right now. I'm 3 pounds above my fighting weight.
I wish I was 223.
That was a hell of a run to get. It was like a bizarre fast of weight loss and booze fueled.
So are you saying if I get 3 bottles of Tito's, I'll lose 8 pounds?
Well, here's the thing. Vodka's keto, right? Has a low carb content, which is why it's special. Secondly, the only thing I ate in 3 days were two steaks. I only had 2 steaks. I didn't have any carbs. I didn't have anything. So I went 3 straight days in almost straight ketosis. And when I was done, the only thing that I've been drinking are literally bottles and bottles of smart water. Come on, it's not my first time at the rodeo. I mean, it's been 26 years, but I'm pretty good at self-maintenance and knowing what my body's telling me because I do train, or I used to train in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Feel free to follow all the links and go read the Yelp review. I used to train at a place that was for competition. Like, I'm very aware of my body. The funniest thing is walking around here with my mom, who keeps looking at me going, "What happened to your ass? You have no ass on your body right now." I said, 8 pounds.
Yeah, that's the first place I lose it.
There you go. All right, let's set out. We'll make this show fun for a while.
Okay.
I'll be the show project. Based on your knowledge of me.
Yes.
Okay. I want homework till next Sunday.
Okay.
And I'll do it. Don't get crazy. I even said that.
No, you got to do a fourth.
You already know me. You already know me.
You already did the fifth. Now you got to put it down on paper.
And this is a real-time show. Wow. This is probably the single most helpful show that we've done to date outside of the suicide show, I think.
To other people.
Yeah, to other people. I mean, the other ones were all kind
of... for me.
Well, yeah, it's good for both of us.
Either doing that or breaking somebody's legs.
By the way, I don't want to say that we've had 2 weeks of breaks of doing this show, and that may have contributed to my relapse.
Probably, or the 4 years you haven't been to a meeting.
It's longer than that.
Okay.
I keep estimating it. It's got to be somewhere between 5 and 10, I think. But yeah, but talking to you or talking to you on a daily basis or even touching base with James.
Right. Right. It only takes two to have a meeting.
And truthfully, with James, I'm shocked at, like, when I first left and started living back at the beach, my whole goal was, I'm positivity guy, right? I listen to positive motivation.
Right. The affirmations.
Right.
Yeah.
You noticed the dramatic change in me. It was all about everything's got to be positive all the time. That's right. How you make money. That's how you should live life. And every time I talked to James, he was just always so angry and negative and upset with school, and I'm upset with Bruce, and I can't believe he got this, and I can't, you know, it's but the haves and the have. I'm like,
are him and Bruce a couple?
No, Bruce is the other buddy, who the Tombstone guy.
Oh,
I haven't told the Tombstone story to end the show.
Doc Holliday.
So I get a text from James about 3 or 4 weeks ago. He goes, "I can't fucking believe it. All right, it's already negative, but I'll go down the road anyway."
Right.
I said, "What happened?" He goes, "Bruce got fired from selling mattresses." He got let go. Okay, he got fired from the mattress store in Tombstone.
Well, there's only so many mattresses you can sell in Tombstone.
I know, we've had that talk before.
Yeah.
Then he got a job.
As a teacher
at a local high school. Apparently, there's a rule that when they need a substitute, anybody with a degree of any kind can move in.
I've substituted.
He went from making almost no money.
I substituted.
Making no money to being a school teacher, and James was pissed off about it. He goes, "I can't believe this guy, and I can't believe it." I'm like, "Why are you so negative? Why does this bother you so much?
Why does it affect him? Does he go
Why does it affect?" Yeah, right. That's always been my thing with my ex. It's my thing. It's like the thing I strive for. Why is this bothering you?
Right.
I would like to believe that there are people who've listened to this show long enough to hear the negative version of me, and I want to believe that over the last 3 months, people see a more positive side to me. Because there's a lot of people and a lot of things that have come into my life, even over the last few weeks before this happened, that some of them will probably not sit well with my ex in regards to doing business with certain people. Mm-hmm. But nothing I can do about it. I'm really interested in making millions of dollars and, you know, securing financial obligations. I'm probably for her. I'll be honest. I will probably.
Well, if you did it together, you got to pay it together.
You should have thought of that before you picked him. I think you got to struggle a little. All right. Eat some soup and ramen for a while and give me a call. Because I know he makes no money.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're not the right guy to ask on that topic because you are a scorched earth sponsor. You'd definitely string these two way up further than I would have.
But I want to sat out in front of the house. Given the chance.
The what?
I wouldn't obsess about it till given the chance. There was a guy with 50 years, my first year, said to me, he's like, listen, one day God is going to put those in front of you that definitely have it coming to them. But until then, don't think about it. And it's, and he was right. One by one, there would always be some confrontation out of the, I mean, my first H&I, my first jail meeting, I got cold cocked from the, in the back of the head by somebody that I knew from the streets. And I was like 3 years sober.
Right.
And, you know, I must have pissed him off enough to, for him to remember that. And I wasn't allowed to do jail meetings anymore because I went into a whiteout, which I guess usually happens with my fight or flight deals.
But, Mr. Please, and for those of you that are new listeners, go listen to the Miami Vice episode. Yeah, you have a look. While it was happening, you were partially fueling my insanity of doing insane shit. Why didn't you tell me to throw the computer into the ocean? That would have been the smart move. You know what I'm capable of with a keyboard.
Yeah, okay. All right.
Okay, here's a real question, right?
No, what's ego the bro code?
What's the bro code?
Well, you don't mess with your buddy or someone you do business with.
Right.
Or somebody that hires you. You don't go after anybody right. in their life.
By the way, would you like to hear her response on that?
And it's not like you could beat his ass because he's your instructor.
Right. No, he'd kill me. I invited him down. I invited him down to come talk to me. No, I actually invited him down personally.
I'm surprised he's not banging down your door right now.
I invited him down.
Probably saved your life that Saturday night by telling him to come over.
I don't know.
Just saying.
Probably. And it would have been quick, easy work for him. But that's not my point. So I whipped the whole bro code thing out on her. Would you like to hear her response? She goes, weren't you
a pro?
Wait. This is my favorite thing that she said. She goes, were you not a professional speaker who was on the road banging every real estate agent that wasn't bolted down? I said, I was. Don't you think that created wreckage? I do. It's why I stopped that lifestyle. I was tremendously out of control as a speaker.
Right.
She goes, isn't this the same? I said, no, because none of them were your personal friends. She goes, you know, I tried to put it into place if you had done it with, she named a couple of names. I go, you're not even really friends with those people. You're like, the people you're rolling off aren't like, you haven't trained with them, spent time with them, gone out with them, right. done things, met Smart their significant them. Others. Like, I had this guy down to San Diego a month ago for a fight with his real girlfriend. Yeah, I'll say that. His real girlfriend.
His official
girlfriend. Who would you like to hear her response on that? She knows what she's got.
Ooh.
She's all
Good
in.
Good for her.
Right? She's all in.
I'm going to LA next week.
Right? Good for her. She's all in on her fun and merriment. She's found all her justifications. She's probably figured out the right level of Tito's to make it okay in her brain. And still be able to have the fun. Good sex is good sex, man. I can't shit her on that one. Like, if it's working, it's working. That's me being an adult about it. All right, give me my homework.
Fourth step. Put down on paper.
Everything I did?
Huh?
Everything I did?
No, the whole resentment, fears, and sex inventory. There's no sex inventory.
You want me to do the old school five column bullshit?
Yeah.
It's five columns, right?
I don't know.
I feel like there's a spreadsheet for it now these days.
There is.
Oh, okay.
Google it.
Send that over. All right. I'll do it. Just
resentments, fears. I mean, where's really the fear in all this?
There's no fear in all this. I mean, truthfully, she's probably right.
Well, there's got to be a lot.
I
think you're afraid that you can't, that this is something she did that you can't put back together now.
Yeah, I do. You're right. Yeah. I think you and I both know that she and I just keep crossing tracks and we just always wind up back with each other.
Right.
I don't know if this is one that I can finally digest.
Right.
This one, so again, this one.
She may have been doing you a favor.
Maybe, maybe. That's what one of her friends told her, the one that I tried to steal away. He actually goes, if your goal was to burn the bridge, you did it fantastically. But I think that part of her decision-making was not based on that. I think her biggest decision-making was wanted to hurt him, want him to see it, wanted to dig it a bit.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think she thought that the reaction would be what it was. I don't think she had any idea of the scale of my...
Right. She probably thought you would send her a sex tape of you and somebody else.
Right. Something else. Yeah. Right.
That's what I like to do.
Or whatever imaginary thing she thinks that I'm up to, right? Sadly, that's probably the worst part. If I had some action going, this would have been a no-brainer. Would have been a good for you guys.
Right.
You just make it really easy, and now I can come out and tell you point blank of what I'm up to.
Right.
And that's probably the biggest stinger, right? It just happened. Okay.
Right, yeah. Yeah, we'll see.
You know what? Monday is a big day for him. He's got to go back to work and deal with the wreckage I created for him.
Yeah.
Monday, he'll be gone, right? All the fun of the weekend's over, and she's got to go back to her life, and she's been...
Tell his landlord to hide his daughter?
The what?
Did you tell his landlord to hide his daughter?
Did I tell his landlord to hide his daughter?
To hide. The landlord, if the landlord's got a daughter, he should hide her away from there.
No, I didn't. I didn't think of that one. My craziest thought, which I played with for most of the day, was literally running a concentrated Covina Facebook ad that links back to my Yelp review. $50 goes a long way on Facebook.
Good.
That's pretty good.
Free lessons if you got a female with you.
See, you're the wrong guy. You're the wrong guy at this moment for these crazy ideas.
I am. I would light everyone on fire.
I know you would.
And then I'd make amends with some stranger later.
Remarkably, I handled this far classier than I ever thought I would.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm shocked just you didn't get in the car. So I'm glad you did.
I did the only rational thing I could do to keep me from going and being a complete dumbass.
Right.
Which is something we've talked about. I'll say it again at the end of the show. If your choices are suicide or homicide, just pick up a bottle. Jesus, so much easier.
Right.
I'm not beholden to any group. I don't have any weird shame issues. I thought there would be a lot of, I thought I'd have that. I'm very shameful for my drinking. I feel terrible. Honestly, I know that I can't control it.
Where would the shame come from? Walking into a meeting and standing up saying you got less than 30 days?
Yeah, they don't know me. They wouldn't know me to whatever meeting I went to.
Right.
I don't have a regular group. This isn't like even a weird ego thing. I could go to a meeting and play the whole newcomer role probably with no issue. And everybody will just welcome me in and, good for you, right? And hug me and put coffee into my hand and whatever.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's the international sign for somebody to swoop in and come and help him. Oh, he has less than 30 days. He needs help. Give him a hug. He needs a cookie. You need a cookie. You want some carbs? Here's some
definitely
carbs.
You have the women lined up, that's for sure. You're a newcomer. You have all your teeth. You have a good job, a nice place. You can still put together complete sentences. Winning.
Yeah. But I'd have to hear other people.
You. That phone rang all the time.
Okay, yeah, since we're being honest here,
everyone disappeared. It was like I quit dealing drugs or something.
Since we're being honest today and putting all our cards on the table,
mm-hmm.
You want to know what one of my biggest...
Dr. Pepper, by the way.
Yeah. Pellegrino Pepper, for everybody light. Concerned.
Mm-hmm.
One of my biggest issues with going to meetings after I was a professional speaker was that I started to judge the speakers on speaking quality.
Of course. Close your eyes. What I have to do.
Is it really?
Yeah, I mean, you listen to the same shit over and over from the same guy. You got to. Otherwise, you know, you're going to miss the message. Because sometimes those jerk-offs actually have something good to say, but because they're such jerk-offs, you don't listen. So you got to close your eyes.
We're starting to turn it into one of our regular shows again.
Huh?
And I currently don't have any position to talk shit about those people anymore. So, yeah, that's a humbling thought.
Yeah. Well, I don't, you know, you know my story. I went through 4 years of abstinence and I was better off drinking, which I did. It just took me 4 years to get back. But I was never here. I was never in the rooms. I never, you know, okay, I have a problem. Okay, I'm angry at God. Okay, this isn't going to work for me. Because nobody told me to get a new act. And I wasn't beat up enough, I guess.
Maybe. I would have wished to have seen if I had control over it. That would have been really would have made me happy if I found out.
Well, if you're somewhere in your third bottle, I think no.
No, but if to tell the truth.
You could have got the same effect from three glasses, not three bottles.
Over 3 days? We're talking Thursday to Wednesday to Wednesday evening to the no sleep.
You've already missed meals. You've already missed sleep.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I mean, I only got a few hours of sleep from Friday to Saturday before I got up on Saturday and started my day. And Friday night, I just stayed on the computer till 5 a.m. destroying shit. Mm-hmm. Like just clack, 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 clack. I did what I do very well. And it scares me how bad you can fuck someone up with a computer. Jesus.
Hey, you saw it happen to me 3 months ago.
Shocking. Shocking level of clack, 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 clack.
Removed from boards of nonprofits. Not allowed in a couple of sobriety clubs. Stupid.
The funny part is everybody, I've talked to a few people. Oh, he'll just dispute that with Yelp and get that review taken down. I said, I'm one of the highest rated Yelp guys out there. I've actually done Yelp podcasts. I'm one of the upper ranked guys because I actually use Yelp mostly for positive. I rarely write a negative review. And what I wrote was extremely accurate. And it wasn't slandering. It was extremely matter of fact, nonchalant, accurate. Yeah, he's screwed. Yeah. And it's at the top of the page because it's the most recent review. If I were him, I'd hire a robot to start cranking up reviews.
Or I'd call Yelp and get the $5,000 package.
Right, right, right. That'll be fine. You'll get moved to the top of the page.
Yeah.
That would be – or you play ball with Lee and see if you can talk Lee into taking it down.
Right. Or
I don't even know what I want anymore. Honestly, I don't even know what I'd want anymore because I got lied to the last – I took it down the last time. I had it up, the clack, clack, clack on Friday. And then they lied. Then they lied and still went back to it, right? Maybe they're just having a full weekend fling and that's the end of it because, you know, they're going to bring this to a close over the weekend. But clack, 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 clack. I went right back at it when, you know, he lied again. He went even a step beyond the bro code. Yeah, man to man, we're even... You do this, take that down. I'll walk away. Okay. Man to man. Clack, 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 clack. If it wasn't for her friend that I had to give up in the divorce, literally on Saturday night as I was driving back from Riverside after watching my daughter, because I was just blowing her up with texts. He goes, if you even care remotely for her or any kind of future whatsoever, you will stop. You will obey these wishes. I am pleading with you to stop what you're doing. And I said, you know what, Robert? Because it's you, I will give you up in the divorce, which that's a bad loss for me. But I just started a podcast with him, so.
It seems like he's lying to you, too.
Yeah, but he got me to stop.
Yeah.
Got here to my mom's, chewed on a few of those Costco sleeping pills that did not help at all. Probably was the food issue, I would think. I'm starting to think now, having had a nap this afternoon, my biggest issue was not eating in this process.
Right.
And probably some level of detox. I'm sure my body wasn't prepared for the sheer volume of toxic chemical.
Right.
And since I've had a low-grade sweat since this thing started, that I'm sure is purely fireproof. But, yeah.
Gatorade and sugar.
I went with water with electrolytes.
Same thing as Gatorade.
I'm a little disappointed she still hasn't taken the time to reach out and to put closure to the matter. I'm sure that'll probably happen Monday or Tuesday if she's smart. But maybe she'll just keep going with the, I don't need to talk to him.
Yeah.
But you and I both know that's not going to happen.
Yeah, eventually. Eventually you guys are going to have to talk.
Eventually. And so there you go. So you just want me to do a four-step?
Yep. Right now.
Right now?
No, before next week's show.
Oh, yeah, before next week's show. All right, what else? I'm playing ball with your system.
That's it. You're not going to go to meetings, so I might as well not
tell
you.
That's not true. Yeah. Let's be realistic about this.
Yeah.
All right? I'm not going to do 90 and 90. I barely did 90 and 90 the first time I did 90 and 90.
Right.
What would be a real number that you would be impressed with?
3 a week. Every other day. Morning. Start your day.
I feel like I want to squeeze one more drunk in before I have to do that. If no. I'm going full program.
No, that's not full program.
Three meetings. Look, 3 meetings is real program.
Not to somebody that's got 2 days sober.
All right.
You want to just write as Lee sees it?
I do.
I wish I could find my copy of As Ian Sees It. I don't know what the hell happened to that.
All right. You're going to be impressed if I go to one anyway, but I'll try for three.
Right. Try for three. If you go to one, you go to one.
If the first one is a complete car crash, I don't know what to tell you.
Well, it's going to be a car crash. Maybe look up if they have the thing around here that seems to be popular is the We Agnostics group.
No, I'm going to probably ease in with a speaker group first. Get me a Friday night speaker show. I'm getting anxiety thinking about this. My God, the anxiety's back going to meetings. Oh, it hurts in my chest. God, I can't believe the level of disdain and disgust I have for the program. And exactly what I have to deal with, which is exactly why I didn't drink for 26 years. Oh.
Right.
And for those of you wondering, yes, I made it to the anniversary of 26. And if you're drinking only once every 26 years, you're doing okay.
I would say so.
I would say so. It would mean I get to squeeze one more in before I drop dead.
I don't know about that.
My heart hurts. Like literally, this is the chest pain I felt on Saturday when I found out they lied to me again. Like thinking about going to meetings hurts my chest that much.
Jeez.
Jesus. I can't, like, I'm getting sweats thinking about going to meetings. Oh.
Maybe you should go to, like, a sex addicts meeting or something.
I'm not a sex addict.
No, but they're fun.
Okay.
I should say they're fun. They are different than other 12-step.
I went out with a girl who was an SAA girl.
Mm-hmm. Lucky you.
And ultimately became way too freaky for me, and I couldn't handle her.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody listening, every guy's going, I could handle freaky.
Freaky's only freaky for a little bit, then it's fucked up.
I think Adam Carolla had the best line. He was talking about being a contractor and when living with a stripper. He goes, but it's like eating waffles every day. Every day, waffles with all the sauce and all the whipped cream. Every single, why every day do waffles every day? It's your favorite food, but it's still waffles every day. And it gets old real fast. See, here's the thing that I actually know about this relationship or whatever it is that they have going. At some point, it's going to turn like they're going to have to start talking and it's going to be a real relationship. And that's where the sideways bend will happen.
Right.
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 Unless she's smart and keeps it super light and super airy, which is probably why the Tito's is involved in her life.
Nah, you know who you need to go have a relationship with. We already talked about this on Friday. You don't remember.
Was I drunk at the time?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, then how would I remember?
You remember.
Text it to me.
Yeah, I will. It's not fun.
Painful. I literally am breaking out into sweats over the thought of going to meetings.
Then don't go.
No, I said I would commit and be the guinea pig for everybody else who's got no time thinking that it can't be done. So if I can do something that's beneficial for other people, then I will do it. Really should have went to Vegas. I really should have gotten in a Vegas trip before I stopped.
Absolutely.
Yeah, well, you talked
about cocaine.
Oh, that the blow would have gotten involved in Vegas.
Almost disappointed.
Certainly blow, maybe Adderall. God, who knows?
Adderall. My doctor keeps telling me about Adderall.
It's speed?
I don't know.
It's speed?
Is it?
Yeah.
Like caffeine speed or like...
Speed, like meth speed.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Why would a doctor...
Because your mind... Like my mind, it will
an X-speed freak speed.
No, because the reason you did speed, the reason I did coke is it ultimately calms our brains down.
Right.
Right? That's why.
Brings our brain into balance.
It's like Ritalin or anything else.
See, I didn't like Ritalin. Ritalin gave me heartburn.
Yeah, this is the same thing. Adderall, all those, they'll...
I don't want heartburn.
You get real hot and itchy.
Yeah, I don't want that shit.
No.
It's like taking niacin.
Yeah, I don't know about that.
Nice, and it's a good flush.
There you go. All right, there you go. Message of hope. It's got to be on your end. It's not on mine. I'm still debating. I'm literally still debating Facebook ads.
Well, Facebook ads are nothing.
It's more scorching.
Well, I understand that.
And actually having this call with you has really talked me out of doing any more scorching, which is kind of disappointing.
Well, calmed you down a little bit. You got it out of you.
Yeah, I guess.
I mean, I don't know. I'm going to light something on fire. I'm going to watch it burn. I'm not going to sit there. I'm not going to put it out with the fire extinguisher.
It's not fun unless you text it to him. And you, as Diana always points out with me, you're not going to be happy till you get your pound of flesh, which is why she's waiting out the conversation.
Right.
She knows that I'm going to need at least a pound of flesh for this whole situation, for being wrong.
Right. Well, not for being wrong, for being lied to.
Well, it's the him thing. Like, it's not the her thing. I keep saying it. It's not her. It's him.
Right.
God damn it. Yeah. It's the him thing. Pretty bad. There you go. Yeah. Okay.
All right.
Message of hope for this week.
Message of hope. Well, no matter how much time you have, if you slip, you can start right back over again. And that's...
This conference will now be recorded.
Oh, crap.